Good afternoon. I want to talk about how I attempted to make I wanted to educate my children in both Japanese and English. That was my purpose. And when the children were born in the United States, that's where I was living in a New York city suburb, New York suburb, I attempted to speak as much as possible both Japanese and English to my children too. I was, I am married to a Japanese lady, and she also speaks English very well. So both of us attempted to educate our children in the two languages. When they became of, let's say, when they grew up to be about 7 or 8, they went to elementary school in Tenafly, they went to elementary school in New York suburb, and he was enrolled in as a first grader, a first grader. And my second child is a daughter, and so a few years later than that, she also went to, before she went to the elementary school, she was admitted to kindergarten. After having lived in the New York suburb, we have tried to speak as much as possible the Japanese language at home, and also, of course, English language, talking about the affairs at home. But when they started going to school, I wanted to make sure that they have no problem adapting themselves to the new environment. So our emphasis was more to English rather than the Japanese. Then, as they grew up, I was working for a company called the Nippon Steel, New York office. And they told me that I should expect to be transferred to the headquarters in Tokyo fairly soon. So that's what happened in August 1971. About 1970, about that time. We went to live in Tokyo, in a company owned apartment near Tokyo, and our children, I was able to enroll my son in as a fifth grader, I believe that was, and my daughter as in a kindergarten. So the emphasis, of course, had to be Japanese, because they're going to the Japanese school, and I didn't want them to be embarrassed not being able to speak the language. As they grew older, in 1971, when my son was 11 years old, he had graduated from the elementary school, and he went to junior high, I believe that was called, in nearby where we lived, and he was admitted to. We had some difficulty. Let me go back a little bit. When we came to Japan after having lived so many years in the States. Initially, we had difficulty enrolling our child, especially the son. He was, we had difficulty in enrolling them in the fifth grade of the school, elementary school. But because they had misgivings, the school was concerned that the child may not be able to speak enough Japanese to manage the lessons at school. But I tried to convince them that we had made necessary preparations in the Japanese language. In fact, there was a special school set up in a very timely manner to give special lessons in Japanese language to the children who were being rotated back to Japan. So she took the boy took that course for about 6 months. I had to take him to New York City, and he was very unhappy. He was very unhappy because that took away a lot of time from his that he would have otherwise spent playing with his children, with his friends. But anyhow, we gave him, I believe, sufficient training, sufficient education in the Japanese language to be able to start work as a fifth grader. It took some doing on our part to convince the school that he should be given a chance, and any difficulty that he might run into, maybe due to not to his lack of ability of the language, but because of the new environment, and which may cause him to be cause him some difficulties, but I tried to convince the school that he should be able to get over it. And they finally relented, and they accepted the child as the full-fledged fifth grade pupil. My daughter had no such difficulty. She was given permission to enroll initially in the kindergarten, but finally as the first grader. But in 1971, when my son was 11 years old, he had graduated from the elementary school. So he went to, I took him to enroll junior high school nearby. Then he was admitted okay, but almost immediately he was subjected to harassment or bullying, you might call it, because his command of English was superb. And his schoolmates, classmates, may have resented that. But because of that experience, that may have given him the reason to not like the Japanese language. And but our daughter, who remained in the elementary school, had no such a difficulty. And today she's back in the States, of course, and she started to study Japanese language on her own. Then we were in Japan for, let's say, almost exactly 3 years. And by that time, their language was predominantly Japanese. And they managed their schoolwork without any problem in the Japanese language. So when the time came for us to return to New York office, after three years, we returned to the States, and first we landed in Los Angeles from Tokyo, and in a hotel in Los Angeles, something remarkable happened. That is, both of the children, he was 11, he was about 13 or 14 years old. The girl is 4 years younger. As soon as they sat down at the table in the hotel restaurant, they started ordering the food in English. I had expected them to be not to be able to do that, and I was prepared to help them order lunch. But they went ahead and read the menu and placed an order with the waiter. And we were served breakfast, or rather lunch, without any problem. And I would be interested in how this sort of thing came out. Apparently, somehow, both kids, they must have had English vocabulary and syntax in the subconscious level of their mind, and once the environment changed, they all came out on the without hesitation. So when we finally came to look for a new home, I had no reason to engage any special arrangement for the children to have a refresher course in the English language. So our adjustment back in the States went very smoothly. And in the meantime, my son had grown and he had his own child about 19 years ago or so. And while he and his wife, who is a Japanese, they were trying to raise their children, I urged them to raise them bilingually as I did, as I had done. But somehow they did not do that. So today he's a 19-year-old student in Waterloo University in Canada, who speaks flawless English and writes beautiful English, but no Japanese at all. So that's roughly the history of my attempt at bilingual education for the two children. So thank you very much for listening. And the final achievement of my own children. Today, the boy speaks Japanese and English very well. The girl speaks English and Japanese much better than her brother, and he somehow, because of his unhappy experience with the junior high being harassed by his school classmates, he does not have a good memory of his junior high days in Japan, but such was not the case with his sister. So my daughter is bilingual in as far as the daily conversations are concerned, but when it comes to discussing difficult or complicated matters, both of them, as a matter of fact, turn to English. So my bilingual education may be partly successful, but not completely successful. Thank you. That's it.